Hello. In this video, we'll talk about necroptosis, which is a method of cellular death. When we hear the term necroptosis, two things come in our mind. First of all, necrosis and apoptosis. Both necrosis and apoptosis are ways of cellular death. And necroptosis is a hybrid of these two. Necroptosis is regulated necrosis mediated by several death receptors. So here are some key features of necroptosis. Unlike necrosis, necroptosis is highly regulated programmed cell death. Unlike apoptosis, necroptosis does not involve caspase activation. But there are a lot of similarities with necrosis, like loss of ATP, swelling of the cell, generation of the ROS, and ultimately leakage of the lysosomal enzymes. But at this point, we should understand why cells need different ways to die. Because apoptosis is already a programmed format of cellular death, then why do cells need another programmed death pathway? Caspase activation is a hallmark of apoptosis, but we have to remember that caspase activation is not seen in case of necroptosis. When it comes to apoptosis, it is involved in several developmental pathways, because it has been seen that several mutations in the caspase cascade pathway leads to developmental defect, whereas several mutations in the necroptosis pathway didn't show a dramatic developmental phenotype. That kinds of point out that these necroptotic pathways might not be useful for developmental progression. But necroptosis has been implicated in pathology such as acute tissue damages, myocardial infarction, stroke, or ischemia reperfusion injury. In case of apoptosis, secretion of cytokine is absent or very less. So there is no immune activation in case of apoptosis. Whereas in case of necroptosis, inflammatory cytokine release is one of the hallmarks which leads to immune activation. Necroptosis is evolutionarily conserved in the vertebrate phylum, and it turns out to be an additional defense to pathogens. Let me explain how. There are many pathogens, especially viruses, which can infect the cell and it can block caspases. So these viruses encode specific enzymes that can break caspases or they can block caspases. So obviously, if caspases are blocked, these cells would not be killed by the immune system, and that would give a green card to these viruses to survive in these cells. But in this scenario, necroptosis ensures that cell death happens. So it's kind of like a fail-safe mechanisms, and it also it is another mechanism which protects our cells from these kind of viruses. Now let us talk about briefly about the signaling pathway. It turns out these necroptosis pathway can be triggered by several signaling mediators. At receptor level, TLR3 or TLR4, TNF receptor, interferon receptor can trigger this kind of necroptotic signaling. Now, the downstream signaling molecules are not well described. There are some molecules which are well described and characterized, such as RIPK1 and RIPK3. Both of them are kinases which are involved in several aspects of the necroptosis pathway. Eventually, another kinase known as MLKL3 is an important player. But whatever is downstream to all of this is a certain event, such as lower production of ATP, generation of increased ROS, which can eventually damage the lipid membrane and lead to lipid peroxidation, DNA damage, and eventually leaking of the lysosomal enzyme and thereby death of the cell as a whole. So, in this video, we discussed the overall concept behind necroptosis and its implication in development and disease. So, if you like this video, give it a quick thumbs up. Don't forget to support me on Patreon. You can also support me on Bheem UPI app if you're an Indian viewer.
You can take my Unacademy course and use my code AP10 to get a 10% discount. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Do let me know in the comment if you have any suggestions or you want any particular topic to be described in a video format. So you can always tell me. Thank you.